Sith,
When they say more money, more problems, I'm thinking I don't got an option. I'm working on facing my conscience. I'm taking no sorts with no losses. I'm finding some peace when the meds came. I'm finding some peace when the chairs came. I'm a provider, that's the best thing. I do it for y'all, that's a mad thing. Yeah, do it for y'all, that's on everything. I stay on my job, that's on everything. Give it to them hard, that's on everything. I stack all these racks, that's on everything. I buff on these packs, that's on everything. Ain't no going back, that's on everything. We all stay strapped, that's on everything.
Forced into a situation for obliteration. Stuck us in the projects and started us racing. Kissing up the game like we bout to hit a base. Stacking money, cause we have to show them what they really facing. Invest in a motherfucking vest. We about to go to war and it's never gonna rest. I know there's no peace in the streets of America, a land where the dark people stress. Oh yeah, it's one of them things. At the time that we hang, I can see all the pain in the eyes of the brain. It fuels my fire like a kerosene blaze. When I learn about your heritage and work, I'm a slave. If my ancestor did that, then I can do this. Definitely prove this. Niggas on his own shit. Taking my heritage, I'm strapped with that metal piece. So your motherfucker better see citizens. Confidence, diamonds with a little wild home. Wing to a diamond by a carpet, five tries. Have a coke and a smile. If you not with the movement, I bleed for my people every inch, every mile. Fly away, don't like what I say. I'm coming for mine and you all gonna pay. I can see you afraid with a little bunny yankers and a mule that you promised yesterday.
Okay,
I do this for my people, not equal, we original. Kinda make sense when you motherfuckers copy style. I can break it down like a motherfucking pound. Never round if you really wanna get it right now. I do this for my people, not equal, we original. Kinda make sense when you motherfuckers copy style. I can break it down like a motherfucking pound. I'm around if you really wanna get it right now.
Yeah. When they say more money, more problems, I'm thinking I don't got an option. I'm working on facing my conscience. I'm taking no sorts with no losses. I'm finding some peace when the meds came. I'm finding some peace when the chains came. I'm a provider, that's the best thing. I do it for y'all, that's a mad thing. Yeah, do it for y'all, that's on everything. I stay on my job, that's on everything. Give it to them hard, that's on everything. I stack all these racks, that's on everything. I buff on these packs, that's on everything. Ain't no going back, that's on everything. We all stay strapped, that's on everything.
I ain't watching training to kill it, I say it's all. They can't face it like a maker, the best of two damn songs. Call the nigga in the cross, they master what's called boss. Like you bust up at the job, the cycle is not long. Not to mention prison, not living, they kill you so long. Can you see the plan killing, ain't no people with a call. It's awful, but no one is left staring in awe. We so geese, is a top children, on kill them all. This world crumbling like Mary Jane. Just to keep my focus clear while I'm driving the left lane. The woods switch lane, but it's so my damn pain. In the past, raining on the brain is different, brittle pain. This ain't my only excuse, this is how they made me. The six people in my head and they all hate me. But I'm a soldier, you motherfuckers can't take me. On everything I love is the truth, you can't break me. The souls of my ancestors, listen to my spirit. If you hear it, it's enough to make you care what fuckers fear it. My life is like a bus and I'ma be the one to steer it. I'm fighting for my people and everything till we clear it. The march of progress and you know we fed up. You really gonna hate us when we get our bread up. Send up black nation, I'm getting impatient. It's time to make the doctor really see the sick patient.
When they say more money, more problems, I'm thinking I don't got an option. I'm working on facing my conscience. I'm taking no sorts with
no
losses. I'm finding some peace when the meds came. I'm finding some peace when the chairs came. I'm a provider, that's the best thing. I do it for y'all, that's on everything. Yeah, do it for y'all, that's on everything. I stay on my job, that's on everything. Give it to them hard, that's on everything. I stack all these racks, that's on everything. I puff on these packs, that's on everything. Ain't no going back, that's on everything. We all staying strapped, that's on everything.
As Mr. Flavor, I am proud to bring to you Mr. E, the music maestro.
And I am so proud to be here today on Revolutionary Hour, B.O.S.S. Radio, baby. We love to bring it to you. We going live right now. You know how we do it on Revolutionary Hour. We bring y'all everything y'all really need to know in order to be able to conquer this world that we've been forced in. You feel me? So now, we really have to discuss the Miracle Society, Moorish Nationality and Status. And it's a very good book, very full of a lot of details. I've read this book twice already. I just can't help getting all the information I can get out of here. Hold on, wait. Yeah, you know. So we're going to be discussing, we're still on first chapter. You know, we've been discussing the first chapter for the past 2-3 weeks now. And I definitely want to delve right into this because it's got so much information. Last week we talked about expatriating. Pretty much leaving a nation's citizenship and pretty much claiming your sovereignty, but not in the form that you probably think it of, because you know sovereign citizens movements have come and just fucking made that word into a cuss word. No, people don't really know what the word sovereign really means. You know, Because if they did, then they would understand you cannot be a sovereign and a citizen. In order to be able to be a sovereign, you have to give up the protection and the privileges that a nation awards you for being a citizen. You know, so what happens when you do that? You know, we discuss statelessness and how statelessness means pretty much you belong to no country. You come under protection of no country. If something was to happen to you, there would be nobody to come and pretty much make sure that you get justice. You know, somebody could kill you dead in the streets. And once they find out that you belong to no country, then that's just it. The person who killed you dead in the streets will not be punished for it because there's no law protecting you from being killed dead in the streets. Which brings us to the black man and the black woman. See, we have all adopted these codes, these labels of black, and calling ourselves Black America, where there is no constitution that protects black Americans. You know, we have to actually either become full-fledged United States citizens and give up the labels and follow up under the ways of the Christian nation of the United States, or you expatriate from that nation and join another nation that will protect you. And that's called repatriation. But before you do that, if you decide that you like how your boy Cat Williams say, you know, I don't think we need another president right now. Can we date around, flirt a little bit, see what's out there, you know? No, you might want to stay stateless and just, you know, study the nations, because there's so many nations out there that people don't even know about because of the simple fact that whenever they're showed a map, a geographical map, they're automatically thinking that every nation is on that map. Not realizing that map only does not show you the nations at all. What it does is it show you the landmass that is on the planet Earth. But it really doesn't have anything to do with the world that we live in. The world, as you know, from definition, means the interaction of the human beings or the interaction of a people on a planet and or in a society. And so you know that we are in our own little world over here in the United States, whereas China is in their own little world, Russia is in their own little world, certain African countries are in their own little world, so on and so forth. So by being stateless and you actually looking around at these different nations and seeing exactly what they can offer you, we can do that as a United States citizen too, but it's just a little bit more, a little less restrictive whenever you are stateless, you know. So you're looking at these nations and you decide that, okay, I think as a Moor, I want to go back into the Moorish Empire. Well, you can find, there's plenty of Moorish nations out there, because if you don't understand nationhood, then you really don't understand business, because nationhood is really just for commerce purposes only. A lot of people don't understand that. They think that it has everything to do, you know, be a patriot. They throw it all into their private lives. You can work or be a part of a nation and not actually have to invest your private life into that nation. You know, this is more for civility and it's more for commerce, you know, to help. Well, a nation was created originally to help people's rights be protected. Other than that, we was able to be able to live free lives. But as you know, in the United States, it's become more every generation is more and more restrictive. And less restrictive at the same time. You know, now they want to legalize marijuana here. At the same time, they want to take away your guns. So you know, it's always it's something you have to weigh. The pros and cons you have to weigh yourself, but you cannot weigh these pros and cons without all the information. Because if everybody knew that there was a such thing as statelessness and or expatriating and then repatriating, I believe a lot of black people would actually opt into that in order to not be seen as the enemy, not be seen as oppressed, or not be seen as a slave. I mean, they always say the United States was not a country that was built for us, you know, for black people, excuse me. So why don't you join the nation that was actually built for you? So we're going to be discussing a little bit about that. You know what I'm saying? We're not going to take too much time today. We're going to try to get this done in an hour. You know, we got to be getting ready for it. If y'all are listening from Lufkin, Texas or East Texas right now, y'all make sure y'all join Southside Beauty Care tomorrow as we have the grand reopening of the Farmers Market in Angelina County. We're going to be definitely out there. Y'all come out there, get y'all some natural soaps, essential oils, some fragrances and shea butters. You know what I'm saying? Make your skin feel better so you can feel the best you. You heard me? We're going to be out there all day tomorrow, Wednesday, May 1st. That's the Angelina County Farmers Market and the Southside Beauty Care. We will also be broadcasting our reggae album from out there. So y'all make sure y'all tune in tomorrow night as we broadcast that reggae album and let y'all know how the Angelina Farmers Market grand reopening was. It's going to be a massive success. It's so many people that's excited about it. Over 1,000 people have already said that they're going to be out there tomorrow. So that is a lot of people. If you definitely want to get you a booth out there, you got a small independent business, you want to actually get out, get started, this is the perfect time. Go down there and talk to Lynn Marie and Tommy Bryan of the Swap Shop on 1340 AM here in Lufkin, and they'll definitely be able to get you a booth. I mean, it shouldn't cost you too much money. You know, it's a small investment. You hear me? You probably get the booth for no more than $50 for that whole day. I mean, you get electricity along with that too. So definitely come out there, check us out. If you want to just come out there, have a good time, bring the children after school or bring them before, during school. If y'all, I'm going to have my son out there. So y'all definitely make sure y'all join us. That's going to be the Angelina County's Farmers Market, May 1st, tomorrow, the grand reopening. Join Southside Beauty Care. You heard me? Already. So we were talking about repatriation, you know, and a lot of people don't really know what that is. But before we get into that, I actually have to go ahead and please these lawyers, you know, yeah. People all up on my man. Never mind, you know what I mean. So just give me one moment. B.O.S.S Radio, Southside Bosses, its owners and associates take no responsibility for the opinions or statements made by the talk show host or their guests. Statements or show topics are not necessarily the beliefs of the site or the radio station, and opinions between talk show hosts may conflict. This site does not endorse anything as the truth that you will have to judge for yourself, but we try to speak the truth on the owner's behalf and reserve the right to question the supposed truth. In this time of misinformation, government-controlled media, and government corruption, it is sometimes hard to get to the truth, but we must try. It is not our intention to libel, discriminate, make hate, or annoy anyone. We believe that it is our constitutional First Amendment right of free speech to voice our opinions and our duty to the Constitution and country to expose the truth. This site takes no responsibility for the opinions of others and the postings of comments in chat rooms or forum posts. Yes, so you know, we are right back at it. Now, I want to take the moment to explain what repatriation really is, you know. Now, according to Black's Law Dictionary, the fourth edition, repatriation is the regaining nationality after expatriating. So, pretty much, you give up your national citizenship of the United States of America, where black people are just the 14th Amendment citizenship, because that's how you was inducted into the United States nation, you know, by the 14th Amendment, not by national status. That's why you don't have a nationality. But anyways, hey, we know American is not a nationality, so get off that nonsense. Which nationality? And is it a North American nationality or South American nationality or Central American nationality? And even those break down. Anyway, back to what I was saying. Once you leave the United States, you decide after, because you know last time we talked, expatriating, you get to leave the United States and become stateless. And while being stateless, you could be roaming around, doing pretty much what you want. Now, when I say roaming around, that doesn't mean your life has to change. You can still stay in the same house, apartment, whatever you were staying in, keep the same job as long as you know how to go about this the right way, which could be discussed furthermore with the Moorish Society, so go definitely look them up. But when you repatriate, you pretty much, you found a nation, especially blacks, if you found a Moorish nation, you go and you talk to the caliphates and the sultanates, and you find out what you have to do in order to be able to become a Moorish citizen. And once you do that, you become a Moorish American and get your nationality back, your Moorish nationality. Now, the book goes on to say that, therefore, Moors must repatriate back into the Moorish Empire, which comprised of many Moorish nations. Now, again, we talked about the map not showing all the nations. That's because the map is a geographical map, not a map of the nations. Nations do not have land per se. Nations have a jurisdiction that covers an expanse of land. That is all. Now, the Moorish Empire was wholly comprised of various Moorish nations, so there is no single particular Moorish nation that has ever existed by itself. Therefore, the term Moorish nationality is relative to those Moorish nations. Now, the Moorish empire is always, no, people always getting the word empire and nation confused. If you actually think about it, the Roman Empire, because it controlled Egypt, it controlled Greece, it controlled Phoenicia, it controlled, after a while, it controlled Spain. I mean, not Spain, but more Spain. It controlled Morocco. It controlled pretty much all of North African countries and the so-called Middle East, which is really North Africa, Northeast Africa. But it controlled all that. But it was called the Roman Empire, and it had dominance over all these other nations. So when you think about the Moorish Empire, it's not just one. And see, this is where the Moorish, this is one of the things that I have against the Moorish Science Temple of America of today. Because the Moorish Science Temple of yesterday, which I'm talking about the one that the Prophet Noble Drew Ali started, he knew that there was many, many nations within the Moorish Empire. And he never claimed that the MSTA or the MDMN, the Moorish Divide Movement, National Movement, MDNM, will be the whole empire. He never said that. He said he was bringing you a way to come back to the Moorish Empire so that you can regain your nationality. And so that means that the MSTA, as it being a religious organization with a 501c3 plan, it could be more considered as a religious movement, while the MDNM could be considered a nation. But I really have to do a little bit more study on that. Don't take my word for it. Do some more study on that. But I can tell you right now that the MSTA is not a nation. It's not a Moorish nation. You can join them, but it will be another faction of the United States, which is okay as well, as long as you know how to work up under contracts and how to get out of the contracts that the United States government put up on you. I'm not knocking your United States citizenship. I'm just saying know who you are so you can make these decisions on your own instead of having these decisions made for you. Now, when El Moor should also repatriate because it provides the building blocks and create avenues to rebuild our nation in the west of Americas, in the west or the Americas. Seeing how the Moorish Empire was actually in dominance of this land before the Europeans came over and established the United States, which is not, now don't get this wrong, when they established the United States of America, it was not out of foul. It was not out of negligence. We was not turning on our own. What we was doing was we were sharing the earth with the European, as we have been doing with other nations for time immemorial. So, by letting the United States come over here, they created pretty much a corporation, the United States, that they would be able to govern themselves as, but it would be separate from the Moorish nations or the other so-called Indian nations that was already on this land at the time. So that shows you right there that it was always a plan to be multiple nations on this land. But it's pretty much just like how you have a Costco, a Sam's Club sitting right next to each other. The same thing. Or you have a 7-Eleven and a Valero right next to each other. You know, or you have a H-E-B or you have a Publix sitting right next to a Winn-Dixie or a Brookshire Brothers. Same thing. Some people may go shop at Brookshire Brothers, some people may go shop at H-E-B, some people may go shop at Publix, some people may go shop at Winn-Dixie. But those are not saying that they are to be at war with each other. No, I mean, yeah, it is a competition to see who you can get more clientele or get more customers, so on and so forth, but it was never supposed to be a war. The war came later on whenever, you know, people started getting greedy or starting getting tricked into things, you know what I'm saying, so on and so forth. So that's what happened to the nation over here. When it failed, we were taken as prisoners of war. So now in order to be able to come out of what we are in right now, we would have to be able to get out of the people who actually conquered us and turned us into prison of war, the government of the United States and the government of the United States only. Stop blaming individuals that don't really have no power just because you say they got privilege. Hell, you know you will exercise that privilege too. I would. Shit, I don't blame them. Anyways, I do blame the United States government for violating the Treaty of Peace of Friendship, where it actually took us into prison, turned us into prisoners of war, and made us work for them as slaves. But when you Moors, like it's pretty much said, Moors cannot have one foot in and one foot out because it will only cause more complications in our efforts for freedom. Meaning that you cannot be in a United States citizen and be a Moorish citizen at the same time. Because subjugated, colonized Moor is a black person. All the things that Moors seek when they first come into the knowledge of being a Moor is all the reasons why Moors should repatriate back into the Moorish Empire. Now, these things such as travel rights, immunities from colorable law enforcement agents, police, etc. are all the benefits of Moors repatriating back into the Moorish Empire. Now, let me delve into that a little bit. Now, when we say the colorable law enforcement, that is strictly the police. This is not the sheriff. We have to remember that the sheriff is covered by the United States Constitution and is being covered by the Constitution and us having a treaty with the United States government. The sheriff would still be a law enforcement agent that you would have to actually show respect to. But at the same time, though, when the police come and on the scene, you can tell them once you show and prove who you are that they must, in order to contract with you in a conversation, they must get a sheriff here in order for your rights to be protected. And they would have to abide by that, or they can have immunities thrown at them. And I know what you say. Oh man, what you say? Black people, we've been suing the police department forever, ain't getting nothing out of it. Yeah, you're right. Black people ain't gonna get nothing out of it, but Moors have been doing it. You know why you don't hear about this stuff? You do not hear about this stuff because A, the oppressor isn't gonna tell you, and B, y'all don't listen. We tell you about these things. We show you these things. We tell you. We actually have the evidence to actually put it out there. But at the same time, you don't really take the time to sit down and read it. But if you sit down and read it, I guarantee you, you'll be like, oh my, I want this. Now, when they talk about travel rights, you know, y'all giving up y'all rights to be able to get around on the land that God put you on. You got to remember, the United States government did not put you on his land. God put you on his land. The Creator put you on his land. So, he gave you rights to move around. Well, you sold them to the United States government and just so you could be able to get driving privileges. So, you took your own fate out of your hands and you gave it to somebody. After God gave it to you to say, protect this with all your might. If you do not protect this, tragedies will befall you. Calamities will befall you. Now, look what happened. You gave up your rights and now you wonder why they arrest you whenever they pull you over with a suspended license. Or you wonder why they're taking your personal conveyance, your car, whenever they pull you over without insurance. You're wondering why these things are happening and not realizing that these things have been foretold from the beginning of time. Now, this means that we as Moors have abandoned our governments and nations to be subjects and citizens of colonists. Moors are in an organized fashion. There's a caliphate and a sultanate. Now, if you take the time to look at that, you will find that we gave up all of that. And that's what Kanye really meant by slavery was a choice. He doesn't mean that we chose to be slaves. What he means is that we made the decisions in order to get ourselves in the position that we were in. And we were in plenty of positions where even if you actually take the time to read history, you'll see there were more Nat Turners than Harriet Tubmans than the ones they tell you about. And these are the ones who chose not to be slaves. These are the ones who chose not to fall victim to oppressors and fight for what they deem the most precious thing in life, freedom. Now, you ask yourself this. Am I in a position to free myself? Am I in a position to make my life better than what it is? Am I in a position to be able to have my children live great lives? Yes, you are. You just don't want to read. That's it. So stop making that decision. Stop abandoning your government and come back to it. Now, all entities, governments, nations, countries, etc., operates primarily on an admiralty level, which isn't restricted to just interaction on the high seas. It involves general commerce, we talked about earlier, especially arrest, detainment, etc. This is why the components are always referred to as ships, townships, memberships, citizenship. Moors have to get off of the U.S. ship and get on the Moorish ship if you actually want to see a change. That's the only way you're going to actually be able to see a real change, unless you're just in a position with the United States government to where you're comfortable. That's different. If you're comfortable and you want to stay there, by all means. But if you're not comfortable and you're trying to, you want to get out of the situation that you're in, you have to get yourself out of it. And we have the jewels right here to help you get out of it. Now, an expatriation must be accompanied along with a termination statement. Also, certain U.S. codes stipulate that U.S. citizens have the right to terminate contracts. Therefore, it is important to exercise the process of dissolution, which would terminate the contracts attached to the persona you are a surety of before expatriation. Now, you can't, if you leave the United States government, this doesn't mean that you aren't, you're not responsible for your the contracts that you had entered into before you expatriated. You have to actually, every contract has a way that you can get out of it. That's what he was talking about with the dissolution. Every contract has to have a way for the contract to be opted out of in order for it to be an accurate and valid contract. Without that clause, that contract is that, without that clause, the contract is null and void. Excuse me. And by being null and void, it means there's your clause right there. There's your escape right there. So that's one of the first things you should look for whenever you sign a contract, or looking to sign a contract. And that should be the first thing you look for whenever you're looking to get out of a contract. So basically, if you do not have that, you do not have anything that can even be remotely utilized for you. Now, you will find a statement that says to turn Moor or Turk in several articles in Moorish and British treaties. And we will be putting up these different treaties here to show y'all pretty much what they say. We'll be putting them up. Definitely go to our join our group page at True Heritage on Facebook. And we will definitely be having these up later on tonight so that you can be able to read these and understand exactly what is going on when it comes to being able to repatriate back into the United States. But now we're going to just go over here to read a few of them. And the first one is the treaty between Great Britain and Tripoli that was signed March 5th, 1675-76. And Article 20 states that no subject of the King of Great Britain and Company shall be permitted to turn Turk or Moor in the city and kingdom of Tripoli, being induced thereunto by a surprisal whatsoever, unless he voluntarily appear before the Dey or governor with the English consul's dragoman 3 times 24 hours in a 24-hour space, and every time declare his resolution to turn Turk or Moor. Pretty much saying you have to make this statement. You cannot just say, oh, I'm Moor today, and expect everybody to respect that. They should respect that, but until you actually declare it on paper, or if you actually until you actually put that in writing, in intelligible writing, to the right people, to let them know that you are terminating your citizenship with the United States to become who you all have always been, a Turk or Moor, then you will be considered a Turk or Moor. But without that, you would never be considered that by U.S. government. Now, this will, it comes in with God Bless Your Soul, Corin Gaines, which is why I keep saying, be careful who you learn from. You have to learn everything before you start making actions. What happened with Corin Gaines is that somebody was misleading her, teaching her out of emotion. I said this before, but it was teaching her out of emotion, got her riled up, seeing the spirit in her, seeing the soldier in her, and they misled her. They told her wrong information. And by telling her the wrong information, she placed herself in a deadly situation. Deadly situation. Now, don't get me wrong. We all know the police was wrong. But how can we fight them if we're not on the standing ground to fight them? It's been years. What have black people done for Corin Gaines? What have black people done for Sandra Bland? What have black people done for Trayvon Martin? What have black people done for Philando Castile? What have black people actually have done for these people who lost their lives because of injustices against them? We're trying to show you a way right now. Now, that was the treaty between Great Britain and Tripoli on March 5th, 1675. But they have been signing treaties for a very, very long time. The treaty between Great Britain and Tripoli signed July 19th, 1716 is Article 21. That no subject of the King of Great Britain and Company shall be permitted to turn Turk or Moor in the city and kingdom of Tripoli, being induced thereunto by any surprise whatsoever, unless he voluntarily appear before the Dey or governor with the English consul's dragoman 3 times in 24 hour spaces. Again, it says the same thing because they wanted to matter of fact, it was 40 years later. It was exactly 40. It was 40 years later. Then, on September 19th, 1751, the treaty between Great Britain and Tripoli also states in Article, believe that is 19, that no subject of the King of Great Britain shall be permitted to turn Turk or Moor in the city of Kingdom of Tripoli, being induced. It says it again. It goes on to say it again in the treaty between Great Britain and Tripoli signed at Sales in 1791. It says Article 10, no English subject or person under English protection, because you know they had to change up the wording, because without the proper wording it would make it null and void. But it says no English subject or person under English protection shall be permitted to turn Muslim, being induced thereto by surprise, unless he voluntarily appear before the governor with the British consul or his deputy 3 times in 3 days, and each day declare his resolution to turn Mohammedan. Mohammedan on here is spelled M-A-H-O-M-E-T-A-N, but it really means Mohammedan, which is really the Muslim that worship under the Islam that Muhammad, the Prophet Muhammad, had brought to the world. Now, when we talk about Muslims, now, I know everybody know what a mussel is. A mussel is pretty much a shellfish that's similar to clams, and it was definitely not something that should have been, just like with the Cameroons. You know, Cameroon was a shrimp, was the Spanish word for shrimp. And now we have a country named Cameroon, and you have the people there that named themselves Cameroonians, meaning they are shrimp people. Now, we know they're not shrimp people in real life, but because of the conquering of the island by somebody who spoke totally different language, they was able to actually name them whatever they wanted to name. This is what they mean by history is written by the victor. Now, Muslim is a German version of Musulman, meaning Muslim, was a slang term used amongst captives of World War II, Nazi concentration camps, to refer to those suffering from a combination of starvation, known also as hunger disease, and exhaustion, and who were resigned to their impending death. Now, a lot of people think about what happened in Germany, and they think about the Jews. Now, I even heard something, I'm sorry I laughed, but I'm not laughing at the Holocaust. That was a horrible travesty that no human should ever have to go through. But I did hear something today. I don't know if I was watching the news, but he was talking about pretty much. I was watching the news. He was talking about the synagogue that got attacked and whatnot recently, and it said that the Jews have been suffering for centuries. Now, that statement we have come to know to be false. Because before 1940s, there was no Israel nation, you know, and it was actually established by the United States for the Jews that was coming out of the Holocaust. Now, they did have a horrible, horrible travesty happen to them with the Holocaust, but this did not go on for centuries. I think what the dude was probably referring to was the original Hebrews, the ancestors of Abraham, Isaac, and Jacob, that have been suffering for centuries. And you know, a lot of people don't understand that these Hebrews is also Moorish and Muslim by religion. They keep thinking it's Judaism. It really wasn't Judaism. Judaism was created by the Orthodox Jews that migrated into Israel after Israel was desolated by according to prophecy out of the Bible. and out of the Quran as well. Y'all just see this was saying we gotta read more. But anyway, that's on religion. I don't want to go into that. But that shows you right there that even Muslims have been going through travesties for a very, very long time since they fell, since the falling of Tripoli. Now, it also goes on to say in that same treaty in 1791 that Article 11, any English subject or person under English protection turning Moor and having in his possession goods or estate the property of other English subjects, all such books, papers, goods, or estate shall positively be delivered to British consul or his deputy, that they may be conveyed to their true owners. Meaning that if you was borrowing something as an English person, you couldn't borrow it as a Muslim. You couldn't borrow it as a Moor. You couldn't borrow it as a Turk. Now, this is going to quote the Sultan El-Amir al-Mujahid, one of the writers of this book, and definitely the writer of the next book we're going to be going over. Y'all definitely need to tune in for that one. But it says that the following government correspondence on the nationality of Moorish subjects in foreign residences between Mr. Philip Charge de Affairs to Mr. Roof, Secretary of State, August 3rd, 1906, American Legation, Tangier, August 3rd, 1906, is proof the truth on how Moors in America legally lost their nationality or waived their Moorish national birthrights, which ironically was published before the establishment of the Moorish Science Temple of America. I don't think Noble Drew Ali knew of this documentation because it disproves 1774 denationalization statement. Uh-oh. So now let's read this. It says, this is a letter to Morocco. Mr. Philip charged the affairs to Mr. Root, Secretary of State, August 3rd, 1906. American Legation, Tangier, August 3rd, 1906. Sir, there are strictly speaking no Moroccan laws relating to citizenship of Moorish subjects in Morocco. The fundamental laws of this non-Christian country are based entirely upon the Islamic code, no part of which treats of the subject of citizenship. There are, however, numerous treaties and conventions between the various Christian countries and the Moorish Empire by means of which citizenship in this country is defined. But, as I understand from the above acknowledged instructions, that it is not the desire of the department to call for a report upon such lines. I would therefore confine these remarks to general conditions existing, which may possibly be of some use in connection with the information desired. Pretty much saying that since there is no citizenship laws with the Moorish Empire, that they were going to ignore the treaties that actually defined Moorish citizenship so that they could be able to declare black people or keep black people as black and not declare them as Moorish, so they would never be able to enter the Moorish Empire, claiming the natural birthrights and regaining their land. Now, he goes on to say that these are the key lines that he wanted to speak on. And he said, citizenship in Morocco may be said to be governed by the laws pertaining to the same in other countries, with the exception that all persons residing in Morocco who cannot prove foreign citizenship or protection are considered ipso jure as Moorish subjects. Ipso jure meaning that they're just automatically, it's an acquiescence of them being Moorish subjects. They don't have no other citizenship, they're Moorish subjects. Now they will be treated as such. And 2 and 3, Moorish subjects lost their nationality only by becoming naturalized in or protected by another country having treaty relations with the Moorish Empire. 14th Amendment, naturalization of the African or the slave into the United States government. No longer Moorish, and no longer at that point Moorish subjects. It was established by the Convention of Madrid, concluded July 8th, 1880. As follows, Article 15. Any subject of Morocco who has been naturalized in a foreign country and who shall return to Morocco shall, after having remained for a length of time equal to that which shall have been regularly necessary for him to obtain such naturalization, choose between entire submission of the laws of the empire and the obligation to quit Morocco. Unless it shall be proved that his naturalization in a foreign country was obtained with the consent of the government of Morocco, meaning that you can have a dual citizenship, but if you do not have that permission or that consent from the government of Morocco to be naturalized in a foreign country, then whenever you do come to a certain time period in living in Morocco or residing in Morocco, excuse me, is that what I'm saying? Then you would be given that choice to either give up your citizenship at home and become a Moroccan citizen or not be a Moroccan citizen at all. Now, foreign naturalization heretofore acquired by subjects of Morocco according to the rules established by the laws of each country shall be continued to them as regards all its effects without any restriction. The above ruling has never yet been acted upon, and should this at any time be contemplated seriously, a large number of naturalized people, American and others, residing in Morocco would be affected thereby. 4 and 5. Residence in foreign parts does not affect the nationality of Moorish subjects, and the Moorish government has no means of protecting its subjects permanently residing in other countries, with the exception of a so-called Moorish consul at Gibraltar and a Moorish agent at Cairo, Egypt. Pretty much, if you wanted to be naturalized into another nation, the Moorish government washed their hands with you until you came back. So that was all your decision. All your decision to become a Moorish citizen or stay a United States citizen. But it goes on to say that citizens of the United States, expatriation and protection abroad by the United States, the Department of State, James Brown Scott. This was all written by James Brown Scott, David Jane Hill, and Gilead Hunt. So definitely got to check out that document. And these are legal documents that carry weight. They carry weight. And every day they play a part in your life, whether you want to admit it or not. Whether you want to admit it or not, it still takes a part. It still takes precedence in your life. And you may not even know it. But at the same time, you are still affected by it. So this is why we're saying you got to understand what you're getting into. Because a lot of people don't know what kind of contracts they sign, and they get mad when they have to show up with these contracts. They have to do what these contracts are saying. Now, if you really want to understand what's going on with you, then study and show that self-approved. Because if you don't, well, we already know what that leading to. We see a lot of it every day. People still getting murdered left and right by the police, by the sheriffs, because the sheriff has been compromised. Because we don't know how to take control and make the sheriff do their job. We don't understand that we actually elect the sheriff to hold a job, to hold a position. And that position is to protect us. That position is to make sure that we don't fall victim to scandalism. Quite plain and simple. I have no other way to put that. Scandalism. So if you're really trying to get out of that scandal, you're really trying to make sure that you can afford to live your life and have your children be free so that we can actually raise them the way that they need to be raised, then we actually have to start looking into what we really want. I'm not saying you got to change your religion. I'm never going to say that again. I think a religion is actually a personable thing. Nobody can tell you what religion you can be in. I don't think anybody should be able to put a label on you. You should be able to put a label on yourself. But at the same time, when it comes to civil rights, when it comes to natural rights, and when it comes to human rights, there's only one way to be able to make sure that everybody is treated equally and treated as such. And if you do not know this, then you will always be treated as undesirable. Somebody who doesn't belong. So, With that being said, this is going to be your boy, Mr. E-Boss of the Southside Bosses. We're going to go ahead and tune out and leave y'all with that. I hope y'all go check out this book. Again, go to moorish-society.org where you could be able to get the Moorish Society Moorish Nationality and Status. Such a great book. Such a beautiful read. It has so much information in it. And it's not even a thick book. You know, let me see how many pages it is. It's not even a thick book. You know, it's pretty easy read. No more than 90 pages. Or am I lying? Okay, it has, no more than 90 pages. You can definitely breeze through that real quick. Go ahead and copy it. They actually have some sales going on where they'll be able to hook you up. So go to it, moorish-society.org. Get you your books. Also, we're going to be discussing, after we discuss Moorish nationality and status, we're going to get into the introduction of the Moorish race and nationality. That way we can go ahead and show you people exactly who you are and let you know exactly what your history is, because what we don't really know is how we got into this position, because we thinking that they came and picked all of us up on slave boats and brought 100 million niggas over here on slave boats. I mean, I'm sorry, no way in hell that story, it can be right, it can't be right. We refuse to believe it's right, especially when we know that we have been traveling the seas for thousands of years. And if you do not know this, that's because you ain't picked up a book. Yes, we have been mooring. If you actually go look at the word moor, you actually see that is also an adjective that means to move across the water. No? And that's what we was doing. We was mooring across this whole planet in ships, going from land to land. At that time, they didn't have to really cross oceans. There was really one ocean. But there were still rivers and vast lakes, vast rivers at that. That, you know, the Atlantic Ocean used to be a river, the Atlantis River, city of Atlantis. See, do your research. You'll find out that was all us. That was all us. We did that. This is what I mean by history, but before black history, because they didn't consider themselves black. There was no such thing as a black person back then. There wasn't. Black people were created out of slavery. Yes, black people was a creation out of slavery. So, with that being said, you got to understand exactly what these people have been doing to us. First, you got to understand English is a stupid language for a reason. There's a reason why English doesn't make sense. Why you have words like knife with that silent ass K piggybacking on everything, on other letters and shit. You know, why we got the word can. Means multiple things. May means multiple things. These things means reasons. They mean multiple reasons for a reason. Multiple things for a reason. And it's to keep you confused. So what we need to do is we actually need to start studying English language. And then study other languages. See how they was formulated. I study Hebrew. I have to this day have not found a more beautiful language than ancient phonetic Hebrew. And the way that it's put together, I mean, the letters itself, the characters themselves is poetry. If you ever take the time to actually study them, read Psalms, you'll see what I'm talking about. But it's your boy, Mr. E, Boss of the Southside Bosses. We're going to go ahead and let y'all go with that right there. I hope, like I say, go check out these books, Introduction to Moorish Race and Nationality, and we'll continue Moorish Nationality and Status as we continue to go over and let y'all know before black history was all about. And this is Revolutionary Hour, baby. Tune in. Y'all can follow us on Instagram, Facebook, and Twitter at Southside Boss Connection. You can follow your boy, me personally, at Mr. E, the Gutter Baby. And you can find me on Facebook. You can find me on Twitter at Gutter Baby. You can find me on Instagram at Boss of the Southside Bosses. And also, join us tomorrow if you are in the East Texas area for the grand reopening of the Angelina County Farmers Market, where you're going to see Southside Beauty Care there with all types of natural soaps, including that raw, natural, black soap. We're going to be having all types of black soap, mango soap, mango butter soap, shea butter soap, cocoa butter and black sea soap, aloe butter soap, dead sea mud, shea butter, healing soap, charcoal. Baby, we got it all. Nubian Heritage. We are a sponsor, Nubian Heritage carrier. So y'all make sure y'all come down and just get y'all skin feeling good. We got the oils that help you with your psoriasis or your eczema or even rosacea. such as Karanja oil. We even got aloe vera liquid gel, babusu oil, shea nut oil. Come on down and get some of these oils. Black seed oil is definitely a rave right now because it has been used in all types of skin dermatology secrets and things. And they tell you, hey, yo, well, it's all the chemicals. No, it ain't. It's the black seed oil. I guarantee you that. Well, y'all have a wonderful night. This is your boy, Mr. E. We signing out one more again, baby. You know what it is. B.O.S.S Radio, Southside Bosses, its owners and associates take no responsibility for the opinions or statements made by the talk show host or their guests. Statements or show topics are not necessarily the beliefs of the site or the radio station, and opinions between talk show hosts may conflict. This site does not endorse anything as the truth that you will have to judge for yourself. But we try to speak the truth on the owner's behalf and reserve the right to question the supposed truth. In this time of misinformation, government-controlled media, and government corruption, it is sometimes hard to get to the truth, but we must try. It is not our intention to libel, discriminate, make hate, or annoy anyone. We believe that it is our constitutional First Amendment right of free speech to voice our opinions and our duty to the Constitution and country to expose the truth. This site takes no responsibility for the opinions of others and the postings of comments in chat rooms or forum posts.
Do you want war? We can get you cracking, I'ma bring it to your door. Have you screaming, no, no more, no more. I can leave your body laying right up on the floor. Cause I don't trust nobody no more, no more. Have you screaming, no, oh, 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 no, oh, 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 no, oh, 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 oh. Have you screaming, no, oh, 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 no, oh, 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 no.
With the police killing us every damn day, it's becoming the biggest struggle to wake up with that trouble. Keeping the tail up on my neck, I'm getting no oxygen, start to see double. And all I wanted was the bubble, they throw a rush, they making me stumble. Just because of my color, they say they can never see me as one of their brother, you motherfucker. They leave me the fuck alone, why you gotta sabotage? It isn't like you don't have more than me, you just a greedy asshole. We asked, we not doing that anymore. Y'all kept fucking with us, money ducking from us, and you don't wanna let it be more, so what's the score? How many bodies bleeding on the floor, laying in gore? Tell me, sisters are good, how many tragedies the future has in store? You can see the blast for me and the economy, got us all hanging over edge. We take the survivors because they divide us, so we cannot even count hands. Can't even break bread as they rob and burning our community down to the ground. Taking our leaders, our leaders, they feed us for a technicality, lock them down. Oh, don't look us down like this hasn't been happening since the beginning. We never been winning, sucking the missus, sitting at the adversary's grinning. We know this is war.
Do you want war? We can get you cracking, I'ma bring it to your door. Have you screaming, no, no more, no more. I can leave your body laying right up on the floor. Cause I don't trust nobody no more, no more. Have you screaming, no, oh, 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 no, oh, 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 no, oh, 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 oh. Have you screaming, no, oh, 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 no, oh, 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 no, oh, 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 oh.
The black AKs, 9mm, SKs, anything that's a heater. ARs really good for hunting creatures, a place when it comes showing they features. Tell us why I'm taking down with their feet up, and all the bastards really wanna beat us. They declare war against a population that was already lied to by our teachers. There's a reason why you never reach us. Breach us, crush plans by those bleach thugs. Try to preach us, that's black love. Scared, I'ma die by a police slug. Sisters, stay black, stay strapped. I'm not trying to die hard because they wore me a wave cap. They sensitive, fear for their life like a pit bull. Jumping on a stray cat, that's black. Which side are you on, cuz? If you went to the Uncle Coon ass, don't you get slugs? I can guarantee it be lugs. They don't like you, my nigga, just because you want dick sucks. There's a rule to the shit, man. Come try to explain, but this isn't our damn game. When it came to the champagne, they came with a sham and they left us with pain. I was walking a campaign just to make you understand they made us change lane. We used to be like a man breaking into a big thing. Big things, not moving big things. I know we gotta get our money right before we even try to have a fight. They started this war, won't apologize to her. I'ma fight with all my mind.
We can get you cracking, I'ma bring it to your door. Have you screaming, no, no more, no more. I can leave your body laying right up on the floor. Cause I don't trust nobody no more, no more. Have you screaming, no, oh, 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 no, oh, 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 no, oh, 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 oh. Have you screaming, no, oh, 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 no, oh, 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 no, oh, 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 oh. We can get you cracking, I'ma bring it to your door. Have you screaming, no, no more, no more. I can leave your body laying right up on the floor. Cause I don't trust nobody no more, no more. Have you screaming, no, oh, 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 no, oh, 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 no.
be screaming no, oh, 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 no, oh, 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 no, oh, 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 oh.
We out here in the trenches, every day trying to get it. We live and die for the dollar.
Unlimited.
They say money is the root.
Let's get it.
Feeling like Omar Epps when Pac fell off the roof.
Got the juice.
Live with no regrets. What a real nigga do. That's cause and effect. Some choose to break the rules. I'm blessed with the Jews. Use the pain as my fuel.
Uh-huh.
10 youngers on the corner pushing work. Call them muse. Shawty rather catch a dollar. Learn that shit at school. Wanna cry about the bills. Rent too much overdue. I hear the money calling niggas.
It's time to
make power moves.
Power moves.
If the streets is what you choose, just know one day your dog may turn on you.
Your dog may turn on you.
For that dollar, I'ma let the angels holler.
Holler.
I see it every day. These youngins out here starving, looking for a better way. Unaware of the knowledge. I know tomorrow ain't promise. I hope God hears calling. We live and die for the dollar.
We live and die for the dollar.
We live and die for the dollar. We live and die for the dollar.
We live and die for the dollar.
We live and die for the dollar. Single mother struggling with two, one in the oven. The pressure's on daddy, not home all of a sudden. She hold it down, wearing a crown. Can't tell her nothing like a jungle. Makes her wonder how she keep from going under. Convicted felon, lost hope on his last appeal. Moving dope to provide his fam a decent meal. God, is he wrong for surviving, getting it how he lived? Doing 34, birdie locked behind the cold steel. Working the white man's job, they treat you like a slave. You feel the pain on your back without the whips and chains. This shit ain't designed for you, it's all commercial gain. We live and die for the dollar, call it minimum wage.
What?
Dear God, these crackers trying to kill us. Bring down Exodus before they squeeze another trigger. Technology brainwashing all my little children. Planting bad seeds, corrupting minds by the millions.
Do you
feel it every day? These youngins out here starving, looking for a better way. Unaware of the knowledge. I know tomorrow ain't promise. I hope God hears calling. We live and die for the dollar.
We live and die for the dollar.
We live and die for the dollar. We live and die for the dollar.
We live and die for the dollar.
We live and die for the dollar.
I gotta carry him. Yeah, yeah, I'ma go into this. Yeah, yeah, this is gorilla. Yeah, yeah, I'ma go get the bag. Yeah, yeah, or I'ma get the pad. Yeah, yeah, I'm so cold like, yeah.
Yeah,
I'm so dull like, yeah.
Woo.
We gon' blow like, yeah.
Just
you slipping now. Look what I'm whipping up. This is America. Don't catch you slipping now. Don't catch you slipping now. Look what I'm whipping up. Look how I'm geeking up. I'm so pretty. I'm on Gucci. I'm so pretty.
Yeah,
I'm gonna get it. Watch me move. This is Sally. That's a tool.
Yeah.
On my Kodak.
Black.
Ooh, know that.
Yeah.
Ooh, get it.
Yeah.
Get it.
Work
it. 100 bands, 100 bands, 100 bands. Contraband, contraband, contraband,
contraband.
I got the plug on who a hawker.
Whoa.
They gonna find you like Waka. Blah.
Ooh, America.
I just checked my follow and listen.
You
motherfuckers owe me.
Get your money, black man.
Black man.
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 Get down.
Very life took the